This is Lisa McCormick, and in this mini lesson, I'm going to show you how you can begin to learn how to play songs by ear on the guitar. What do I mean by playing songs by ear? That means I have the song in my head, I know the song, but I do not have the written music for it. I don't have the chords. So I'm going to try to figure out how to play it on my own. In order to begin to figure out how to play a song by ear, we're going to need to do two things, a little bit of counting and a little bit of trial and error. Let's start with the counting. Have you ever heard people talking about the 1, the 4, and the 5 when referring to music theory or chord theory? The 1, the 4, and the 5 are the major chords in any particular major key. Let me show you what that means. If, for instance, I was going to play a song, a basic simple song in the key of C, the C chord would be chord number 1. Then what I would do is count to 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and fill in with C in position number 1, basically alphabetically starting at C. So C, D, E, F, G, and A, 1 through 6. Next, I'm going to pull out number 1, number 4, and number 5. Remember? 1, 4, 5. These are three chords that are going to go really nicely together. So in C, my 1 chord is C, my 4 chord is F, 5 chord is G. And you can hear how those really go together in kind of an intuitively great way. Okay, so there's the counting part. Number 1, number 4, and number 5 coming from an alphabetical list starting with whatever chord corresponds to what key you want to play in. Now for the trial and error part. So let's say for the sake of argument we want to learn how to figure out how to play the song Happy Birthday because you showed up to a friend's party and someone said, hey, you know how to play guitar? Play Happy Birthday. And you say, I don't have the music. Well, you don't need the music. Here's what we're going to do. So let's start the song on the 1 chord, on the C. I'm going to play the C chord until it no longer really works with what I'm singing. So here we go. Happy birthday to you. It doesn't work on the word you. So that means it's time to change chords. So chances are the other chord that I need to go to is one of the other choices, the 4 or the 5, in this case F or G. Let's try F. Happy birthday to you. No. Let's try G. Happy birthday to you. There it is. That works. So let's stay with the G until it no longer works and then try to figure out by trial and error what to put in there. Line 2. Happy birthday to you. Can't stay on G for the word you. I need to go someplace else. I'll try going back to C. Happy birthday to you. That works. Let's try line 3. Stay with the C until it no longer works. Then try one of my other two options. Happy birthday, dear so-and-so. Doesn't work on the so-and-so part. So what do you want to try? How about F? Happy birthday, dear so-and-so. Yeah, I like that. Let's stay with the F until it no longer works. Happy birthday. Right there. I don't like it. So on birthday, we are on F. What are our other choices? C or G? Let's go back to C. Happy birthday to. Don't like it on 2. Maybe G. 2. And since we're in the key of C, I said we're most likely to end the song on C because that's going to sound like resolution. You. So we have. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear so-and-so. Happy birthday to you. In other words, 1, 1, 1, 5, 5, 5, 5, 1. 1, 1, 1, 4, 1, 1, 5, 1. So there you go, a little bit of counting, a little bit of trial and error, and you have figured out how to play a simple basic song in a major key. Now, as you might imagine, this is really powerful information because it really underlies the sensibilities that guitar players use when they are playing by ear, when they're jamming and improvising with other musicians, when they're transposing songs from one key to another, or when they're trying to figure out songs from a CD, or when they're writing their own songs. These are the sensibilities, that counting system. The little snippet of information I gave you today is the very tip of a spectacular little iceberg. Really important and powerful information for guitar players. If you're interested in learning more, I have a mini course in basic chord theory for guitar. I'll put the information in the text section that goes with this video. Have fun.